If you enjoy saving recipes but would like a better way to organize them, I'm going to show you two free programs today that have really saved me a lot of time. The first one is OneNote, which is available for free from Microsoft. If you don't already have a Microsoft account, I will put a referral link down in the description. Creating an account using that link will give you a little bit more free storage space. So right now I'm in the online version of OneNote, and I have a OneNote notebook called Magazine Clippings, where basically I spent one weekend getting rid of a ton of magazines, recycling of course, and taking pictures of the articles that I had wanted to save. The beauty of OneNote is that it's cross-platform and web-based, so you can have it with you almost anywhere. Right now I'm in the online version. With the online version, you can use the camera on your device to insert pictures. However, if you notice in this picture on the right, when I took the picture, it was at an angle, it didn't frame it. So I'm going to show you a slightly different way to use that, that I think is a little bit better. And you're going to want to download an app called Office Lens. And that's available on Android, iOS, and on your computer if it's Windows 10. When I open Office Lens, you'll see it uses the camera on my device. And I'm going to take a picture of this recipe card. And I'm just going to tip my computer, and you'll notice it's at an angle, but there's a beautiful frame right around it, so it ignores the table that the card is sitting on. I tap the camera, and you see it straightens everything out and makes it beautiful. Now I want to save it, and I can actually send it straight to my recipe section. Transferring, close. Now when I go back to here and refresh, that'll take a moment. Scroll down, and there's the picture. And you can see it's framed, all the extra stuff is cut out, and a lot easier than inserting it from the other one. So this is the image when I inserted it from Office Lens, and I can go up here and change all of this and give it the title for the recipe, Peanut Butter Drop Cookies. These are amazing, by the way. My mother got this recipe in her home ec class in high school. And if I go back to the original one, you can see the difference between the images. Another handy part of Office Lens is that you can crop your image. So here's a magazine recipe, and I'm going to take a picture. And if you look up here in the top right, there's a cropping tool. So I can get rid of a couple extra things. And maybe I don't want as much of the picture, though personally I appreciate the picture in recipes, so I can see what it's supposed to look like. And then click the check mark in the bottom right corner, and your image is ready to go and send into your OneNote notebook. OneNote is amazing, but I want to show you one other way that I collect recipes, and that's when I'm collecting recipes online. For OneNote, I could do screenshots, but there's a program that's free that's also pretty amazing, and that's called CopyMeThat. CopyMeThat is an app, and it's also web-based, and it's just copymethat.com, which I'll put down in the description. I'm going to go ahead and log in, and I'm going to log in with my Facebook account. As you can see from the pop-up, I went ahead and paid for the premium version. I believe it was $25 for a lifetime, and there's a reason why I'll show you later. Go ahead and get rid of that. So what this does is I can take pictures of recipes online with a simple click and add it into my recipe book. So let me show you how that works. Once you've created an account, go to your favorite browser and be sure to add the button for copying the recipe. And this walks you through it. Right now I'm using Chrome, so I would go ahead and get the button from the Chrome store. And add to Chrome. Add extension. And as you can see, I now have a new button in my extension bar area. Now let me show you why that button is so amazing. I'm going to go to Bing, and lately the family is trying to eat healthier, so I searched for healthy apple pie recipe. Up here at the top, I can see the ratings, I can see the time. Right now, I want to see the top rated. Let's try this one. So you'll notice when you go to recipes online, there are usually ads because it's people who are using that to make their living. It is their blog. But the problem with that is you've got to scroll through it. It takes forever. It's talking about things that you really don't care about. And that's where the beauty of this little magic button comes in. So I could scroll down through this and see all the pictures. And I haven't found the recipe yet. Oh, there it was, I think. Even better, I'm going to click this magic button. Copy me that. And it magically puts that recipe into my CopyMeThat account. I now go to here, and as you can see, it's extracted all the steps, including an image, and all I have to do is hit confirm, or I could go in and I could add a description. I could uncheck some of these boxes if I wanted to, and later I could also go back and make edits, especially since I like to revise my recipes sometimes. Once it's in, I can rank it, I can say if I made it, or I can mark it as a favorite. Click the pencil. There is a whole lot more to CopyMeThat. Personally, why I got the premium version was this right here. If I decided I needed to make more than one, let's say I needed ingredients for 3 pies, I click scale, and it adjusts all the ingredients for me. So I hope this helps you with your holiday baking and your organization.